The presidency says those who see the investigation of the suspended acting chairman of the Economic and Financial Crimes Commission, Ibrahim Magu, as a signal that the fight against corruption is failing have failed to see the point. In a statement on Saturday, the senior special assistant to the president on media and publicity, Garba Shehu, noted that there couldn't be a better indication that the anti-graft fight is real than the will to openly investigate anyone who has been charged to head such systems. According to Mr. Garba, there are no sacred cows and even Mr. Magu is not immune, regardless of the obvious embarrassment that potential acts of wrongdoing by him, given the office he had, may appear for the government. He also noted that Mr. Magu is being availed the opportunity to defend himself and answer the allegations against him. Meanwhile, the EFCC Director of Operations, Mohamed Umar, has been directed to oversee the activities of the commission. Joining us live is Bolanle Olugbani, who is a legal practitioner. Thank you very much for joining us this morning. Hello, can you hear us?
Yes. Thank you for having me.
It's a pleasure. Welcome. Do you consider the treatment given to Mr. Magu as unfair legally?
Well, the provisions of Section 36 of the 1999 Constitution provides that every citizen shall be entitled to fair hearing.
Yeah.
In addition to that, the police must presume any suspect innocent until proven guilty. And in so doing, within 24 to 48 hours, any citizen must be charged to a court within 60-kilometer radius of the place where he is arrested. So that presumption of innocence until guilt is proven, if not a capital offense, like robbery, terrorism, and murder, he is entitled to bail. You cannot, under Nigerian laws, keep somebody in detention indefinitely, saying that you are doing investigation. So having said that, Mr. Magu is entitled to bail within reasonable time, or he ought to be charged to court. That is the position of the law.
Quickly, let me just throw this in, as briefly as you can. Why do you think that this might be playing out this way with regards the amount of time that he's being held without being charged to court or without being set free? Do you think, you know, the precedent has been set, you know, in the past, and that's why, you know, this has continued?
Well, I think that in their own best judgment, they may consider Mr. Magu to be a flight risk.
Okay.
He may have resources and access to the logistics of disappearing. So if that is the case, they will look for a way to ensure that he does not go out of the country if he's granted administrative bail.
Okay. He also is accusing some sections of media of bias reporting. In your opinion, where do you think the media is missing it, and what other options can he communicate to the media without asking for release?
Well, I think that Mr. Magu himself tried many people by media. The EFCC, under his stewardship, was fond of making stupendous allegations against Nigerians who were accused or alleged to have committed acts of corruption. Those persons' images, their personalities, their reputations were torn to shreds in the media by allegations made by officials of the agency, and indeed the agency, when suspected of corruption. So if the media that was used for that purpose is giving information, salacious information, that Mr. Magu is also guilty of stupendous corruption, well, I think he's taking a plate of his own meal.
All right. And lastly, the presidency continues to say this is an indication of the administration's strength in the fight against corruption and not a dent, as believed by some. Do you agree?
My humble and personal view on that is that in Nigeria, you never get charged or accused of corruption unless you offend the powers that be. Those who are manifestly corrupt with apparent evidence of living above their means, once they are in the good books of the authorities in Nigeria, they are never arrested, talk less of being prosecuted for corruption.
Okay. All right. Thank you so much for your time this morning. We really appreciate it. Bolanle Olugbani, we hope to speak with you again.
Thank you.